गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन हार्ट. द ह्यूमन हार्ट इज अ मस्कुलर स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट इज अ कोन शेप्ड स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द थोरेसिक कैविटी बिटवीन द टू लंग्स एंड द एपेक्स ऑफ द हार्ट इट डाउन इट इज प्रेजेंट डाउनवर्ड्स एंड इट इज पॉइंटेड टूवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट. नाउ हार्ट इज फोर चैम्बर्ड एंड टूवर्ड्स द ब्रॉडर साइड ऑफ द हार्ट देर आर टू चैम्बर्स एंड दिस इज राइट एंड लेफ्ट ओरेकल. This is right and left auricle, and towards the pointed end there are two chambers, right and left ventricle. Here also you see right and left ventricle. Now both the auricles, they are not connected with each other, but they are separated by a septum, and this septum is known as atrial septum. So right and the left auricle, they are separated by interatrial septum. Same, the right side and the left side of the ventricle is also not connected with each other. They are also separated by a septum, and that is known as interventricular septum. Now heart is four chambered and the wall of the auricle is thinner than the wall of the ventricle. Now right side of the auricle and ventricle, they are connected with each other, and left side of the auricle and ventricle, they are connected with each other. Now right side of the heart is connected with deoxygenated blood, and left side of the heart is connected with the oxygenated blood. Now in the right side of the auricle is connected with the right side of the ventricle by a valve, and this valve is made up of by three flaps, and this valve is known as right atrioventricular valve. And in the inner surface of both the ventricle there are certain muscular projections, and these muscular projections, they are known as papillary muscles. In the inner wall of the ventricle there are certain muscular projection, and these projections are known as muscular papillae. So between the right auricle and the right ventricle there is a three flap or tricuspid valve, and this three flaps, they are kept in the position with the help of this muscular papillae, because there are very fine projections which arise from the valve and they are connected with the papillary muscles. So these papillary muscles, they keep the flap into its position. So the blood, it can come from the right auricle into the right ventricle. It cannot go back to the right auricle. Okay, so now there are two veins. One thing I will tell you children, that the blood vessels which enter the heart, they are known as veins, and the blood vessels which leave the heart, they are known as artery. No matter whether they are having deoxygenated or oxygenated blood. So in the right auricle, you see this is one vein which collects the blood from the parts which are present above the heart, and this is, you see here, this is the vein which collects the blood from the organs which are present below the heart. So this is the vein which collects the blood from the organs which are above the heart. You see, this is the opening, and this is the opening of the vein which collects the heart from the organs which are present below the heart. So this is known as superior vena cava and this is known as inferior vena cava. They bring deoxygenated blood into the right auricle, and from the right auricle through the tricuspid valve this deoxygenated blood comes into the right ventricle. Then from the right ventricle one artery is connected. You see, this is the artery, and this artery, it takes the blood away from the heart. Although it is carrying deoxygenated blood, but just because it is going away from the heart, so it is known as artery. And this is pulmonary artery, and this pulmonary artery takes the blood to the lungs for the oxygenation of the blood. Now from each lung, I will show you. You see, from each lung, one pair of pulmonary vein, and here also one pair of pulmonary vein. They bring the blood, which now has oxygenated, into the left auricle. You see, there are four, 1, 2, 3, 4, one pair from the one lung, right lung, and one pair from the left lung. So two pairs of pulmonary veins, they bring oxygenated blood into the left auricle, and from the left auricle through the bicuspid valve, between the left auricle and the left ventricle there is a valve that is known as bicuspid valve or left atrioventricular valve. So this valve allows the oxygenated blood to the left ventricle, and you see, children, that from the left ventricle the largest artery, that is known as aorta, it arises, and it divides into three branches, and then they keep on dividing, and they supply the blood to the different upper part and the lower part of the body. And at the beginning of the aorta and the pulmonary artery there are semilunar valve, and they prevent the backward flow of blood from pulmonary artery to right ventricle and from aorta to left ventricle. So these are the four chambers of the heart, and the arteries and the veins which enter the heart and which leave the heart. And this side, the right side, carries deoxygenated blood, and the left side carries the oxygenated blood and supplies the oxygenated blood to the different parts of the body. So this is the structure of heart, and children, you will study from your book, and you will draw. Two diagrams are given, one external structure, the other internal structure, and then afterwards you will write the comments, and if any problem you can ask me. Thank you very much.